Hello, Buckeye Nation. My name is Lisa, and I'm the gal behind Buckeye Football Fangirl. And yikes, what happened on Saturday? For a team that lost the previous week to Oregon, that was not the game we all expected to see. A game that was competitive all the way until the fourth quarter. All I have to say is God help us, it's going to be a long season. This coming Saturday, we have a game against the Akron Zips, and let's hope that we don't see another repeat of this past week. Join me as I try to make sense of the game this past week and talk about the matchup coming up this Saturday. Nobody, and I repeat, nobody expected Tulsa to play a competitive game against Ohio State. This was supposed to be a game that Ohio State came out angry with something to prove after that painful loss against Oregon. And we didn't see that. Instead, we were treated to a four-quarter brawl that was too close for comfort until late in the fourth quarter. Caitlin and the victory bell summed up all of our feelings as a fan base with these two tweets. This is ugh. And man, this is rough. I was left walking away from the game, scratching my head and wondering what the heck just happened. How did Tulsa just play a competitive game against the Ohio State Buckeyes? Jason Priestess summed up these feelings pretty well when he tweeted, "Tulsa with the ball and a chance to tie the game in the final quarter. What is even real anymore? What is even real?" I think that we all agree with Robert Norvell's tweet. This is not Ohio State football. What we saw on Saturday was not the Ohio State football we are used to seeing. It was not the clean, in-sync, dominating team that we know from past years. It has not been a team that is playing even remotely close to our expectations for them. Now, we all have super high expectations. We are all spoiled fans from years and years and years of high performance from our beloved Buckeyes. There's no denying that. And yet, these first three games of the season have been just puzzling and nerve-wracking. I'm in the same boat as Melissa when she tweeted that my stomach cannot handle these games. And that, my friends, is the problem. A game against Tulsa should not have my stomach tied up in so many knots. I come into each game so fired up as a fan, and I'm sure that you all do too. But what's scary is that we're not seeing that same fire from the Buckeyes on the field. Rudy Buck summed this up well when he said, "Again, this team looks flat. They've looked flat for three straight weeks. Where's the emotion? Where's the energy?" As Melissa tweeted, "This Ohio State team needs fire. I have seen bits and pieces of some fire, but not a whole lot. They gotta find that fire. They gotta find that passion. They need to come together as a team and play like they want that natty." Quite honestly, as SportsFan73 said, only saving grace today is we really play a lot of freshmen. And holy cow, did the freshmen come through for us on Saturday. As Dave Rowland tweeted, "Like I said, pups are biting. Despite an overall head-scratching, heart attack-inducing game, there were quite a few bright flashes from players on the team, and most of them came from the freshmen. I don't need to say it because you all know it, but TreVeyon Henderson is a stud." Alex tweeted what we were all thinking. "Wow, just wow, TreVeyon Henderson. He left us all speechless as he tore down the field time after time for his three touchdowns and record-breaking 277 rushing yards. I think wow sums up his performance pretty accurately." Thankfully, Henderson wasn't the only freshman who flashed. There were several other flashes from freshmen and other underclassmen throughout the game. Burke was a beast throughout the game. As Hello World said, "Ohio State has a lot of problems. Denzel Burke ain't one of them. You all know this, but his interception never should have been overturned. That overturn was ludicrous. My mind literally exploded when they ruled that a catch by Tulsa. Some of the other flashes that I noticed during the game were JTT with the pressure on Brynn, Cameron Martinez with his pick six, Ronnie Hickman with his interception, and Tyleik Williams with that massive sack to Brynn when the Buckeyes needed it most. As Chris Renee tweeted, the underclassmen won this game for Ohio State. The future is now, and I don't care about the seniority slash feelings. Ohio State has some dudes waiting to get their chance. I'm in 100% agreement with this tweet from Don. Henderson is our best offensive player today. Burke, our best defender. Tuimoloau is our best offensive lineman. All true freshmen. Well, thank God for the freshmen. We got the win, and honestly, it's time for some perspective. As Lori Terry puts it, what a weird win. With how this defense is right now, though, I will take it. I will absolutely take it too, but man, our defense better get their act together before, and I can't believe I'm saying this, the Rutgers game. I completely agree with Scarlett Payne era 278 when he tweeted, not happy with the defense, but there were moments that gave me some hope. I've been calling for Cam Martinez for a while now. This team is still under construction, but the W at least puts them in a better place. They are a young team, a team that has been gypped on experience due to the weird COVID year last year. They are a team who is still searching for their identity. But my goodness, did Sam Block hit the nail on the head when he said that the playing ends next week. Ohio State 63, Akron 0. I sure hope this is the case because my heart needs a break from these back and forth games. Speaking of Akron, let's take a quick look at who we're going to see on the field this coming Saturday. Ohio State and Akron have met in the past 8 times. Out of those times, Ohio State has won 7 and Akron has won once. And it's interesting to note that Akron's one win came all the way back in 1894. The Akron Zips are led by head coach Tom Arth, who played high school ball at St. Ignatius. He had stints as the head coach of John Carroll University, where he also went to college, and the University of Tennessee, Chattanooga, before landing at Akron. Last week, he had an unsportsmanlike penalty called against him during the game, which almost cost his team their winning touchdown. I couldn't find what that penalty was called for, but his feet are definitely being held to the fire after only procuring 2 wins in his 3 years as head coach. A lot of people think that this may be his last season there, as a lot of the fans want him gone. So far, the Akron Zips have opened their season 1-2, and it's intriguing to note that they lost their first game 60-10 to Auburn. Auburn limited the Zips to 188 yards of offense, despite Akron possessing the ball 2/3 of the game. That sets the bar in my mind for what Ohio State should be able to do this week, and for me, will serve as a measuring stick. Their quarterback, DJ Irons, is a dual threat quarterback. He's a JUCO quarterback recruit, and he made his first start this past Saturday after playing as the backup quarterback in their first 2 games. Unfortunately, their starting quarterback, Cato Nelson, was injured during their second game, and they're unsure when he's going to be able to be back on the field. Irons started out hot for the Zips last weekend, but then the team struggled to hold on to the lead, and they barely pulled away with that win. Michael Matheson is their go-to wide receiver with 230 yards for the year. He's been called a lovely weapon for them on offense. Jonzel Norris is their leading running back with 114 yards for the year. Anthony Williams Jr. splits carries with him, and he has logged 85 yards also for the year. For some context, Master Teague has logged 91 yards for the Buckeyes this year, so that says something. Bubba Arslanian is a linebacker who leads the team in tackles, with 37 tackles for the year. And Randy Cochran is their leading cornerback, and he was part of the cornerback tandem last season when their passing defense was ranked 5th in the MAC. I really don't know what we're going to see on the field this Saturday from the Buckeyes. Logic is telling me that it should be a blowout, but these past 3 white knuckle games have given me PTSD. I hope with all that is within me that the Buckeyes will come out focused with a passion and a purpose to play that we have all been so hungry to see from them. I want to see the energy just radiating from them and their talent taking over the field. The playing around ends this Saturday. I'm ready to see a team take care of business. Despite what happens on the field against Akron, I will forever love these Buckeyes. Today, tomorrow, and until the day I die. I'll leave you with that, and I'll catch you on the other side of the game.